Slavery was abolished hundreds of years ago, right? Wrong. Today, there are about 27 million slaves in the world. That's more than double the amount that crossed during the course of the transatlantic slave trade. 2 years ago, my family began to sponsor a little girl in northern Thailand. Her name is Busum, and she is one of the few who are rescued from her traffickers. She is also now my sister. It all began after my mother came back from her business trip to Thailand for her company's sustainability initiative. She told me about the rescue home she visited and the kids' history there, and about the little girl who never let go of her waste. As she was telling me this, a force so powerful overcame me and told me I had to meet this girl to help her. I had to somehow help all these kids in this rescue home who are impacted by such a horrible evil. And when every cell in your body, every piece of hair rising up on your skin is telling you to do something, you should always listen. So I flew to Thailand, and when I first met Busum, she was sitting at a table drawing images from a book. We couldn't get her to talk for hours. Later that night, my mother and I took Busum and her sister out for dinner. And slowly she began opening up to me as I practiced my Thai. The fact that I couldn't roll my R's was absolutely hysterical to her, and after that, she seemed like a completely different person. A couple days later, we went on a boat ride in Laos, across the river from Laos is Burma, Busum's hometown. And there was a moment during the ride where she became extremely sad. And in retrospect, it's probably because she was overwhelmed by that sudden flow of emotions and memories from her cross over from Burma to Thailand, hoping to improve her life. These children, they seem like such ordinary children, but they're not. They need our help, and we need to help them. So since I've met them, I've promised myself that I would do everything in my power to make sure she has the life that she deserves, and that no one else will ever have to endure the horror that is human trafficking. So when I got back, I started working with a nonprofit organization, Not For Sale. I started fundraising, organizing movie showings at school, and was asked to fly to Singapore to present my knowledge to a company on their sustainability day. Human trafficking, also known as modern-day slavery, is the exploitation of people by means of force, including abduction and deception. Meaning children and adults are tricked by the promise of a better life, a job, safer environment, food, but instead are forced to work for free for the rest of their lives in terrible conditions. 27 million slaves in the world today. And that does not just mean in the brothels in Thailand or the mines in Mexico, I'm African. It also means in countries like, Europe, United States, and Japan. We have the power to end slavery. Although 27 million people sounds like a lot, it's the smallest percentage in our history. The first step is knowledge. Knowledge is power. Once we educate ourselves on this issue and realize its importance, we have the responsibilities to stop it. When buying products, question where it's coming from. Question how many tired, bruised, small, bloody hands it passed through before it reached yours. Show them that we're noticing and that we care. A couple years ago, that's what happened with Nike. In the 1990s, Nike's poor working conditions were publicized by the media. However, it was not until 1998 where Nike started to improve its policies because consumers were starting to stop buying their products, making their sales drop dramatically. Nike has since improved its standards because of us. Because ordinary people like you and me, we have the power to end slavery. One voice makes all the difference. Companies, multinationals, non-profit organizations, non-government organizations can end slavery. It could have been you, forced to work in that field or sell your body on that street. It could have been you, but it wasn't. By some chance, you were born the lucky one. But along with this rare freedom, you have to change things for the people who can't. You have to stand up against the injustices of this world. It is your future and your planet. It is imperative to act now. None of us are free until everybody is. Years from now, people can look back and recognize us as the generation that ended slavery permanently. Thank you.